be giving up. You can't believe it, it's too much. But I'm tired of you, me on. Oh, I don't like where this is going. And I've been stuck in all your apologies. Gave my all, but you want it all from me. Keep your love, it doesn't feel the same. I hope it hurts you when you hear my name.
Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. The time for talk is over as we are just mere moments away from the Super Bowl. Two teams now have a chance to prove they are the best. It's the Eagles going up against the Raiders.
Larry, this 2017 season has given us enough thrills to last a lifetime, and now only one game remains, and it's the one we've all been waiting for, as EA Sports is proud to welcome you to coverage of Super Bowl 52 from two-year-old U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy. I'm Brandon Gunn. To my left is my good friend Charles Davis, and what a thrill to be here for the biggest one of them all, the Super Bowl. And it seems to get bigger every year. The lights get brighter, the cameras more numerous. I don't know, there's just so much that goes into this game. It's an honor to be here, isn't it?
It is an honor, and I can't wait to share this game with you. This is going to be a whole lot of fun. You're my partner, my best friend. I can't imagine being anywhere else but right here with you. And just think about it this way. You mentioned the magnitude. This is no longer just a game for America or even North America. This is worldwide. People watching from just about every country in the world. This is impressive.
The biggest stage, the biggest game, and just about ready to roll. The eyes of the world upon us tonight as Super Bowl 52 from Minneapolis is underway. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Carry for LeGarrette Blount. He finds an opening past the 40. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. A big chunk of yardage there, 37 yards.
Well, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
And he's going to be out of bounds down inside the 20. And a nice gain of 21 yards. Boy, the evolution of the game and how these guys in plays like that can get out of the pocket, keep plays alive, it just makes things so much harder for defenses.
It really does. And we're talking about an era in the game where the quarterbacks are the most athletically gifted that we've seen in a bunch. I mean, when you talk about collectively, it's unbelievable. So their ability to move is practiced now. It's not necessarily, oh, he just took off and you guys figure it out. When he takes off, everyone knows where to go now. They know how to run routes, change things, make themselves presentable for the quarterback. It's a lot of time that they put in on it. It's not just your static, 1, 2, 3. This is where the ball goes anymore.
Play fake to Blunt. Now it's Wentz. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield.
Oh, no.
In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
That was my fault.
The Eagles are in for six. And we have seen the first touchdown to Super Bowl 52. The first 51 Super Bowls, a team that scored first, they won 34 times out of 51. So two-thirds of the time, but just gaining that momentum's got to be huge in this game.
It's massive, and that's what everyone's looking for. The first big break of a game, the first advantage of the game, and that too, that tends to carry a team, right? Most of the time, you're able to sail on that for a while. Looking for the first touchdown, you feel like you're in great shape.
So here comes the Raiders offense now onto the field. Bringing them out there, a man who switched coast to join the Raiders this year. From Florida State, it's E.J. Manuel.
Such a key cog in their AFC title win 2 weeks ago. Remember what he told us this past week? That he couldn't wait to get out here to this day, to this stage, but also was trying to take it all in as well, trying to slow down the process a little bit so he wouldn't be overamped for the game.
Yeah, he said, I want to slow it down but speed it up all at once. Now the game is here and he's ready to shine. 23 yards on the play.
Defense gives up a touchdown in the opening drive. Offense, you got to want to get out there and get those points back right now.
And that's a sharp throw there to get this drive off to a good start. Now Manuel. And it's hauled in by Jared Cook. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. 23 yards on the play.
I do believe we'll see a little bit more of this game progresses, because when you can have that type of a game in the middle of the defense, it hurts them in so many ways, because most teams like to be strong down the middle. If you can sting them there, that open things up for you on the outside as well.
That's where he, their big tight end, is so good, that middle third, the seam routes, the in routes. Yeah, you're right. Probably see more of that.
Yeah, it takes a lot of courage and fortitude to go in the middle as well, and he's got it. His passing's been on point on this drive, hasn't it? Been very accurate. Gotten the ball downfield, gained nice chunks of yardage. But now, in this situation, the field is really condensed, partner. So if he's going to throw the football, that could be pinpoint here.
As I was going to ask you about that. Field shrinks, has to be sharper, but it's been a good opening drive so far.
Now they just want to see if they can cap it off with the bell ringer and put it in the end zone.
That's good for a gain of 6, second and goal. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4 for 4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it, because now everyone gets locked in. The confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sideline thinking to themselves and expressing, let's keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well. His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back.
Whoa.
It just never materialized.
That is not going to be any help as they dump it behind the line of scrimmage.
That was a big-time stop on third down. Offensively, you'd love to tie the game up here, but 3 points might not be a disappointment.
And this may be a big early turning point in this Super Bowl. They're going to go for it on fourth down here. Here's Manuel. That's caught.
No.
Shy of the goal line. They're turned.
Fuck you.
Take the field. They'll come out throwing here on first down. Crabtree with it over the middle.
Bitch.
A really good pickup of 28 yards.
Hmm.
They go play action here on first down. And they've got
inside
the 10 at the 8. They've got another first down. The Raider passing game clicking on all cylinders right now.
All right, I'm doing my rudimentary math here. That's his third catch here in the first quarter. I don't know if it's just game plan or he's just finding his way over.
Maybe a little of both.
God damn, the defense is hard. Fuck.
Here for a modest game. A nice pickup of 6 there to get him closer to the end zone, and it'll be second and goal.
Okay, no score on that play, but this guy's been a touchdown machine all year long. You know they trust him with the football.
Oh, come on. Is it going
to
be the same thing?
They're able to get him down. Give him 2 yards officially, and now it'll be third and goal. And Mr. Cooper, Amari, a headliner in this offensive unit.
Brandon, it's rare that you get guys
I don't care,
so
hurry
coming
up.
Out of college, but Amari Cooper has carried himself like a pro probably since he was 6 years old. He is a terrific talent.
They'll run for it with Lynch.
Yes, bitch.
He's in. Touchdown, Raiders. Marshawn Lynch taking it in. They're within an extra point of tying this thing up.
But they decided to run it in and got it done on third and goal. A lot of times that's a passing play.
And the kicker, this has to come out for the PAT. He can breathe a sigh of relief as well, right?
Although I don't know if he's really breathing a sigh of relief. I think he likes to put 3 points on his ledger.
So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. So out now comes the offense back onto the field. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. They start on the ground here with Blunt. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. Calling a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. And this O-line, it is the lifeblood of the offense.
They established the tone. Mean, nasty, physical. They can't wait to get after people. That allows the rest of the offense to feel confident.
Wentz to throw on second down. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. 15 yards through the air and a first down. That's a matchup maybe they go back to their outer third of the field as this game continues.
Yeah, I think back to my high school coach, John Ford. He used to say when we got big plays early in a game or good plays, you know, he'd say, foul it away, lad, foul it away, because he'd want to come back to it later in a key situation. They may come back to this one a little more often than that.
Mom? No. Well, yes and no. Mom, do you have a picture of me that shows the colors of my eyes? I don't know.
Say Laddie or did he say Lad?
Yeah, it just depended on what he was feeling at the moment.
Okay, I thought that was the guy you told me about. Say Laddie a lot.
Laddie, when you heard Laddie, he was usually in a pretty good mood. Lad.
And they'll go winch to blunt here. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. 25 yards to pick up there and also a first down.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against?
Encroachment defense.
And he got a little aggressive too early.
And he did, wanting that quick takeoff as the ball was snapped, but I think sometimes those big guys on offense, they're pretty cagey too, right? They make those little sudden moves or those little subtle moves that get you to jump.
Counting down toward the midway point in corner one. Again, here's Blunt. Great footwork, but still wrangled down before reaching the 20. Give him 5 yards there, and it'll bring up second down. Quickly now, the starting 11 for the Oakland defense.
Funny, you remember Reggie Nelson in 2015. Big Pro Bowl year, led the league in interceptions with 8, and signed a big-time contract with the Oakland Raiders after that. Followed up with 5 picks in 2016. An over-the-top aggressive safety who was an absolute ball hawk.
Play fake. Wentz. This throw caught right around the 6. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. 17 yards is the pickup there for number 17.
I know we just saw a nice throwing catch, but how about the big guys up front buying that time? Yeah, that's exactly what they did. They created time and allowed the space to happen, and it turned into a really nice play.
Well, they've been practicing goal line offense all week. Let's see if they're able to capitalize here. Hammering for the goal line. He loses the football. Pick it up, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
And this is something that you know that they're emphasizing, you know they're working on, but it has to improve. Carson Wentz lost 14 fumbles as a rookie, and the NFL is just different. When you're in the pocket, you're always at risk of that ball being jostled out.
And if memory serves, those 14 fumbles tied with Carson Palmer for most in the NFL. Start the drive with Lynch. And not much there as he gets it up to about the 5-yard line. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
That first down play, all you want to do is wedge out any type of space and try and create enough room. If you have to run the punter out there, he can successfully complete the punt.
Yeah, didn't get a ton there, but at least some positive yardage. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And got his man complete. And he gets this one all the way up to the 40. And that one results in 35 yards.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that and have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
A good pickup there, a 22.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? That sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. Now a play fake here on first down. This will be caught inside the 10. And they do get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. That one goes for 36 yards.
They've looked his way quite a bit, and in my estimation, as well they should.
Well, that's now 5 catches, and he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Marshawn Lynch, his second touchdown of this Super Bowl, and the Raiders have taken the lead. And a pair of rushing touchdowns now for him in the first quarter.
And I'm liking what I'm seeing from his big guys up front because they're winning the leverage game. How many times have we talked about low man wins, right? Move the defensive front aside, create those gaps and holes. He's found his way through for 2 touchdowns.
And after both of those touchdowns, he went right up to that O-line and hit each of them on the helmet.
That's a smart man. You know what else he should do? If this continues, take them all to dinner.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Now Philadelphia ready to get going on offense again. And so close to hitting pay dirt last time, fumbling down near the goal line. Now, how does that affect their psyche this time around?
It's a tester, that's for sure, because to be that close and come away with no points is really disappointing, not just for the guys on off.
Looking for Jeffrey, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Obi Melifonwu, and he returns it into enemy territory down to the 45-yard line.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
The Raiders offense now, they trot back out. Well, these guys hardly got a chance to catch their breath after the quick turnover, but I doubt they're complaining much.
Especially with the field position they get to start with, I wouldn't be complaining either. I'd want to get right back out there and get after them because now you have an opportunity to make a big play. I'd say let's be aggressive and go after him.
Play fake. He'll look to throw. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. Give him a first down. 15 yards that time for the Raiders. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change. Get out there. Stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. They've got another first down. The Raider passing game clicking on all cylinders right now. And with that completion, he's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up and feel like you can always bounce back after plays. But with the kind of numbers he's putting up here, it's starting to wear on them a little bit, I think. So they're looking at each other and trying to figure out what defense will work and how can they play better without getting beat deep for big passes.
And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. 11 more on that one and another first down. This offense can certainly move quickly when they want to. 3 plays, 3 pass completions, and the blink of an eye, they've got a first and goal.
Almost felt like a lightning bolt hitting this game, didn't it? For them to get downfield that quickly, and now first and goal, expect them to tap right here on this play.
He'll look to throw, and he whips that one incomplete there. Jared Cook, the tight end, was the target, and that'll bring up second down. And the defense now for the Eagles.
Jordan Hicks battled a lot of injuries while at the University of Texas, but his last season there played up to the potential they saw when he was coming out of high school. Well over 100 tackles, ranged from sideline to sideline, could also drop into pass coverage, and now uses his intelligence to run the entire Philadelphia Eagles defense from the middle linebacker position.
On second down, Lynch. And he's over the line and in for a Raider touchdown. Janikowski now for the point after. It's good, and it is now 21-7. Second down, here's Wentz. Ertz has it left side. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. An Eagle first down there, Wentz to Ertz, and the names that end in TZ.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to, pick up a first down.
Wentz going to give this one to Blunt, and he's going to get this one down to the 45. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
It sets up a third down and four now.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action and hit them over the top.
The Eagles on third down. They've had good success, 5 for 8 to this point. This is third and four. To throw, it's Wentz. And he connects with Ertz. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? Because Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this, or keeps hitting the calculator, but my goodness, what a start he is off to. By the end of this game, he could have monster numbers. He just wants to continue to be accurate.
On first down, Wentz, caught by the tight end Ertz. And down inside the 15 he goes. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. This drive, it's been a good mix. 3 passing plays, 3 runs, hitting on all 3 of those passes, and the last one putting him in the red zone.
So wouldn't you think play action right here? Because you've got the ability and had the ability to run it and throw it. Go play action and take your shot at the end zone.
Zone now, Wentz. This will be caught just inside the 10. And he's got this inside the 10 to the 9 before he's out of bounds. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, Those guys are worth their weight in gold.
So 2 minutes to go in a wild first half. We'll come back to Super Bowl 52 after this. A reminder, coming up at the intermission, we'll get highlights of this Super Bowl from Larry Ridley and the crew in Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Wins to throw again. The quick slant caught. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Alshon Jeffrey, a 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Eagles are able to cash it in for six. These two teams in this first half, it's been fun. Back and forth, back and forth. Well, it's not fun for the defensive coordinators, but offensive coordinators are enjoying it.
Yeah, they're having streaks here, aren't they? Being able to put scores together and really bunch them up, and we have a tight game here. You know, we often talk about having the right shoes for the right turf. Today it's track shoes. That's what we've seen with these offenses.
Yeah, it's been an absolute track meet so far and fun to watch. Sturgis out now to kick this one off. To return, it's DeAndre Washington. And some room to roam now. He's got the lane, and there he goes.
Well, whatever the relationship was between the special teams and the offense, it's gotten a heck of a lot closer after a return like that. The special teams just keep setting them up. The offense thinks they'll go out there and knock them down.
And now Oakland ready to take the field. And right now, these guys, they're shuffling a little bit, maybe doubting, because three straight drives have ended with him punting the football away.
Yeah, so you start pointing fingers at each other a little bit, asking a lot of questions. What are you seeing? What are you getting? Maybe trying to narrow down your playbook a little bit and maybe get simpler rather than more complex in order to try and fashion together a drive.
The pickup goes for 16 and a Raider first down. To throw now on first down. That's complete right around the 8. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Looked like the screen pass was taken away there, and that was a nice job of improvising, but it's not normal. Usually when the screen pass is taken away, you're taught to just throw the ball at the ground at the feet of the receiver so you don't get it intercepted and just start over. But he ended up finding another receiver.
6 yards on the pickup, and it leaves him with a first and goal. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can...
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Marshawn Lynch with a record 4th Super Bowl touchdown tonight. And the Raiders have drawn even here. They can take the lead with the extra point to come. And that one will give them the lead here as we approach halftime. The drive summary that time, 5 plays. And it ends with an Oakland touchdown. Out to kick is Janikowski. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Now LeGarrette Blount gets set to go again on offense. And Charles, you can't really fault him. He's over 100 yards already. He's not the reason they're losing.
And that is really unusual because ordinarily when you've set the tone this way and have run it this effectively, usually your team's in control. So it's a very strange situation. And you're right, you can't fault him. He's done a great job for his team thus far.
I'm guessing he's saying, feed me on the sidelines. Now will they continue to do it? Wentz. Going underneath to Blount. And he's able to get this one up to the 45-yard line. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As he'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. the gun. It's Wentz. Hurts over the middle. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. Throwing on first is Wentz. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he will avoid the contact as he slides to a stop. They'll give him 8 on the play, and that'll make it a second down. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get him with 10 seconds to go before halftime. So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get 3 before half. From the right hash, this from 44 yards out. And Sturgis able to knock it through. And with that, they'll take a 2-point lead here in quarter number 2. So they kick it through to take the lead. There is a little bit of time left, though, here in the second quarter.
And while they're concerned about not giving up a big return or giving up points themselves going into the half, how good do they feel, though, putting points on the board themselves right near the end of the first half?
And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. With time running short here, they'll simply take a knee, and that should do it for half number 1. So these two teams will head back to their respective locker rooms here in Super Bowl 52 from Minnesota, as we'll send you down to Orlando as we check in with Larry Ridley in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
Thanks, Brandon. Thanks, Charles. And welcome to our EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley.
I know when I joke about you guys skipping halftime, sometimes you get frustrated, but this is the Super Bowl. You got to watch the halftime show of the Super Bowl. All right, let's get you to the third quarter.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. Fielded about a yard deep. He gets away from one. Comes the Raiders offense. They'll go on offense first to start quarter number 3. They're close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half 2, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. That one good for 13 and a Raider first down.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
A really nice gain of 25 yards. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
And he's going to get this one down right to the edge of the red zone of the chalk of the 20. That one goes for 24 yards.
Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft Surface tablets, because none of it is working. They are really locked in on offense. Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with
it. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Michael Kendricks, tough to handle on that blitz. He gets him for a loss of five. He didn't get rid of the football there, took the sack, although that's easier said than done. He can't just chuck the thing sideways into the seats.
No, he really can't, because you're not afforded total protection as a quarterback. You have to get outside of the tackle boxes as defined by the NFL, meaning wherever your tackles operate normally, get outside of that. And the ball that you throw has to get back to at least the line of scrimmage. Otherwise, you face an intentional grounding call. They really love to get him into one-on-one opportunities, and this is one way. Work him out of the slot and create a mismatch. Who's going to cover him? Corner, safety, linebacker? He's got a way to beat all of those positions.
Yeah, the D not yielding much there. He's only going to get a yard to about the two.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right. He's pretty much been completely neutralized. They try again with Lynch. And he fights his way into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Marshawn Lynch taking it in from 2 yards out. And once again, the Raiders are back out in front. And that rushing touchdown is fourth, puts him just one shy of the NFL record in a single game.
And we all know he would love to get to that record and even beyond it, but he doesn't need to in order to impress in this one, does he? What a performance. What an absolute great game that he's had here in this one.
And he's able to put it through. So that drive goes 8 plays, and it's all capped off by a Marshawn Lynch touchdown run. Out to kick is Janikowski. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. So here are the Eagles now as they get set for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve.
And he continues to pile up the yardage. That puts him over 150 now. And this defense has really had its problems trying to keep him contained.
Going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. Second down following the run. Now out of the gun and able to get this one all the way up to about the 46-yard line. And he's able to get most of what he needed on the carry there. 7 yards on the gain, and it's third and two now. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him, so when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
The Eagles on third down. 6 conversions and 9 tries. They've done a great job of picking these up. This time they face a third and two. Now Blunt. And he's got a first down as he's up to the 48. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here, because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he might have got this across midfield, not by much. They'll mark it down at the 49. A gain of 3, second down.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense? Was that five straight runs?
Yeah, five straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. Now they'll throw it. Wentz. Jeffrey with a catch left side. And he's going to be stopped dead in his tracks. Looks to be right around the 40. An Eagle first down. Wentz hooking up with Jeffrey.
That was a nicely run slant route. And what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
All right, so the timeout over and all 11 men back out onto the field for the defense. They'll run it now out of the gun. They'll fight forward for a couple down inside the 40.
This has been an up and down, back and forth type of a game, hasn't it? Maybe this long drive will take a little bit of the wind out of their sails, kind of settle things down a little bit.
Now the Raiders are going to use another timeout here. And that's going to leave them with just one timeout remaining, still in the third quarter. We'll see if that comes back to haunt them. We'll be back. And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field. 8 yards to go here on second down. Working from the gun, Wentz. Jeffrey reels it in over the middle. And this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
Wentz to throw on third and one. Aguilar has it, and he gets the first down here as he's taken down at the 24. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height. Sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback who has to slide and find open space to throw.
Stop this dive.
And take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. LeGarrette Blount taking it in from 24 yards out. And the Eagles are able to cash it in for 6.
Well, partner, that was another explosive
nope,
run.
You are not going in, I tell you, but
yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball, too, right?
Without a doubt, you need that difference maker lugging the rock.
And in the third quarter here, they were trying to push that to a 3-point game, but instead it'll stay at 1.
And I'm a big proponent of not chasing points or going for 2 too early. But in this case, I understand why. You know, if you kick an extra point, you're just up 2,
yeah,
right? So a field goal still puts the other team ahead. So you go for 2 here and protect the field goal lead. They didn't get it done, though.
Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. The Raiders offense now, they trot back out. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Did they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Now Manuel. And he'll hit the slant route. That's caught by Cooper. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains. Great change up there on the route and got that inside release, made it a successful pitch and catch.
So the first thing you want to do is have him thinking that you're going outside. Make a move in that direction. Then you really don't run the route against the whole body of the defender. You run against a half of him, and the inside half, and he took it right across his face, got inside, and won that route in a big way.
He's lucky to be getting that one back.
After what they've done with him all day long, with all the targets trying to go after him, he's obviously gotten smart, and his pride has kicked in. Made a terrific play.
Incomplete, almost intercepted. They haven't picked him off yet. Would have been a great time for the first, but instead it's third down.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense if that fell harmlessly to the ground. That one good for 13 and a Raider first down. Going old reliable there to the slot on third down.
And the slot position has become the bane of just about every defense's existence, because how do you cover? Do you go with a bigger guy to try and use size? Got to go with a quicker guy, and sometimes you even get out quick there. Very difficult to match up with that slot receiver. That's why they keep going back to him.
And he's had the hot hand. Over the middle, he gets it to Patterson. That one goes for 24 yards. And on that last play there, he's over 400 yards passing now.
You know what that generally means?
Success.
That, and it means you really didn't miss opportunities. Usually very active. Getting to the right place. Guys are making yardage after the catch to help you out that way. I mean, the whole team has picked it up. And don't forget, that means the offensive line has had to pass protect pretty well, too. Yeah,
everyone dialed in.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Cordero Patterson from 17 yards out. And the Raiders are able to cash in for six. And there they got him the ball. Just get it to him. Let him do the rest.
You know, he probably said that to his quarterback as he broke the huddle. I like the play call. Just get it to me. I'll take care of the rest of it.
Helping out his...
All right, so if I do 43...
Right, RAC.
Run after catch, and he loves that, and he's going to carry that in at contract time.
And he will dive into the end zone, and a two-point conversion is successful. To kick is Janikowski. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Back out for another drive comes LeGarrette Blount. He has a chance to hit that often elusive 200-yard mark on this drive.
And most of the time during a game, people aren't keeping track of individual statistics.
Are you sure?
Well, a lot of the runners kind of know. But I'll guarantee you, someone has sent word into the offensive line that he's got a chance to get over 200 on this drive.
I hate that you have Madden 1-8.
Because they love it when backs break that barrier.
Absolutely. What?
We'll see if he can do it. Not a whole lot doing there, as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
Play fake to Blount. Now it's Wentz. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
I have Madden 1-7.
Nice.
On first and 10, here's Wentz. And bringing it in, the
This is Selleck over the middle. And a big collision there as he winds up flat on his back at the 47-yard line.
I know I spent a lot of time talking about how tight ends in a lot of cases now are pumped up wide receivers, but they're still big people. And he used that frame right there to absorb a really big hit on him and held on to the ball.
Wentz now on first down. And he finds his tight end. It's Ertz. And he's brought down. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
They had two tight ends in the formation on that when it looked to me like he had his pick of receivers downfield.
I think he was just planning on going over the middle. That's what he did.
Picked up first down, too. Mm-hmm.
So here we go, first and 10 now.
I'm sorry for this troll, JJ.
Alright.
They go play action here on first down.
No.
Aguilar, right side. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Nelson Aguilar, 36 yards. And the Eagles are within an extra point of tying this thing up. And on that one, able to catch it, also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then, of course, the run after the catch that ends up in the end zone.
This will be taken in at the one.
No.
Make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The Raiders offense now making their way back out onto the field. And they'll be looking to build.
I have a dick pic.
Last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. A really nicely run drive.
And now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush, pass rush, pass rush. Whether it's the guys up front, or maybe you bring additional guys, but you've got to disrupt the timing of them throwing the ball.
We'll see if they can disrupt it here. Here's Manuel. Cook able to escape. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football. They've got another first down. The Raider passing game clicking on all cylinders.
Get them lawyers.
And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense at every position. The tight ends have created so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time.
Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Second down now after the pass completion. Hand off comes to Lynch. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give him a new set of downs.
T-R-A-S-H.
What we're rooting for in this game, the effort of the man with the football, getting away from one and trying to turn forward and get some yardage.
JK.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
There we go.
Up.
They look to throw now on first down. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. They've got another first down. The Raider passing game clicking on all cylinders right now. And these numbers on our monitor are getting hard to believe. He's closing in now right on the doorstep of 500 yards passing.
I'm glad that you watched the monitor and said it first because I had trouble absorbing that. That's big time right there, right? That means everything just about has gone right for them and his squad in this game. Let's see if they can keep it up.
And this is caught. It's Cooper.
Hey.
Take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Amari Cooper from 17 yards out. And the Raiders have moved out in front.
I know these wide receivers are about flash and dash and high-flying plays. But a good number of them played running back at some point in their career, and that's how they finish off a lot of their big plays right after the catch.
And this time he finishes off the big play in the end zone. to kick is Janikowski. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. And out now come the Eagles. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got 5 here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3-yard gain brings up a third down.
Well, praise has to go to the guys on the offensive line because they've had a very nice, productive day running the football. How about that poor defensive line? They've been knocked around the entire game, and while they slowed him down on that run, can they continue to do so?
Don't he forget to sub, guys.
Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
We all love to have a home run hitter in the backfield. Guy can take it the distance. But a short yardage, trying to pick up first downs, that big guy, always a nice luxury to have, isn't he?
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take this one up close to about the 45. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
Well, he's looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple of yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Now Wentz throwing on 2nd down. And he'll hit Jeffrey complete. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs. Alshon Jeffrey, so dangerous even when a defender's near him.
He's got such a big body, ability to run, positions himself well, excellent control. And you're exactly right. Even if people are draped on him, he often comes up with the catch. He really symbolizes what people are looking for in receivers in today's NFL.
They'll run it now out of the gun.
He's dumb.
Down to the 36-yard line here. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave it with a 2nd and 3.
Hey, when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
So 2nd down, 3 yards to go now. Shotgun now for Wentz. And this is Ertz with it, right side. And he'll go down at the 28. An Eagle first down, Wentz to Ertz.
Like so many tight ends nowadays, they have no problem at all putting him in the slot and letting him go to work. And that's a nice pitch and catch right there for a first down.
Fake here on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Khalil Mack coming hard on the blitz. He dumps him for a loss of 8.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
In a blink of an eye, that happened fast and a big sack. And the 8th play on this drive coming up. Wentz now giving to Blunt on the draw. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. That'll get a little bit back, give him 5 on the run. And they'll be left with a 3rd and 13.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
On 3rd and long, it's Wentz.
Oh,
and they finally get to him as he's taken down. Bruce Irvin in there to get him for a loss of 9, and that'll lead to fourth down. And partner, it's safe to say that the secondary really contributed to that sack.
Yeah, nickel set, 5 defensive backs, they covered everything, nowhere to go with the football. But my question is, why didn't he throw it away?
Here's Donnie Jones now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And that'll hit in the end zone. Much too much leg there. That'll be a touchback. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
One quarter remains in Super Bowl 52. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now here on EA Sports. It's the Raiders with the lead and the football here. A play fake as they set up to throw. And he finds a man with a crossing route. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Given 12 yards that time and an Oakland first down. And the offense lining up first and 10. Throw. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down.
I think he's taking an awful chance with the football right there. You've got a lead. You've got to protect it. And he's taking chances, putting it out there in a little bit of jeopardy.
Especially in a spot like this, fourth quarter, as you said, trying to cling to that advantage.
Yeah, that one probably should have been picked, huh?
And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. They've got another first down. The Raider passing game clicking on all cylinders right now. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. This one caught left side by Cooper. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line. And a nice gain of 21 yards. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Jared Cook, a 22-yard touchdown grab. And the Raiders add 6 to their lead. Janikowski on for the extra point.
Brandon, is there any way you and I can join this quarterback in the zone he's in? He's absolutely feeling it. Touchdown after touchdown, throwing the ball.
That drive goes 80 yards in 6 plays. And it winds up in 6 points for the Raiders. Out to kick is Janikowski. This is taken near the 13. And he'll take it out past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. And, you know, their previous possession, they were able to move the football but still wound up punting in the end.
You know, in 2016, Carolina had a 20-play drive that lasted over 10 minutes. And remember how it ended?
Yeah, a punt.
Yeah, I mean, how does that happen? You just don't see that happen every day.
This one maybe not quite that bad, but still, you'd like to have a chance for points if you hold the football that long.
Agreed. Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old-school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So up through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. On the crossing route, he hits his man, Amari Cooper. And he takes this one just shy of midfield all the way to the 49. That one goes for 24 yards.
Well, how about this aggressive approach? Got the lead, fourth quarter, continuing to throw the football. Are you thinking about Super Bowl 51? Atlanta had the lead against New England, and they ended up giving it up?
I was going to say, don't say it, but you did say it.
I did, didn't I?
Yeah, anybody watching in Atlanta, our apologies. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. 23 yards on the play.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down. Stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. First down, the run with Lynch. Oh, now he bowls him over. And certainly some style points there on the spin. Not a whole lot thereafter, but still a pretty good game. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two. So the solid run on first, and I would imagine no real hurry to run that second down play.
No, it's all in your quarterback now. He's going to keep an eye on the play clock and bleed things down, and he's not going to let the ball be snapped until it's inside 3 seconds left on the play clock. Unless, of course, you're playing a video game, you're trying to run it up on your friend.
Nice touch. Cold-blooded, too. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. A huge loss on the play, and they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. It's a 7-yard run, but it does bring up fourth down.
But once again, a good example of situational football. That was third and very long, so you know they were guarding against the pass. And when they decided to run the ball, that was okay. But every yardage they picked up, as long as they didn't get to the first down marker, the defense was willing to concede, and they stopped them well short of a first down.
So a big one there is that gives them a little cushion.
And you know, here in the fourth quarter, the fact that they were able to bleed some time off the clock and put points on the board, even if it's only three, that could turn out to be the drive that ultimately wins them the game.
This will be fielded at the 8. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. Now LeGarrette Blount gets set to go again. Try and start this drive in the air. Looking middle, and it's incomplete.
When we start looking for big-time corners, we're going to start with athleticism. But without technique, you're not going to make plays as one we just saw there.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. And he almost had it defensively. Could have been a game changer there in this second half. Instead, it's third down.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
Back to throw here. And now another one thrown incomplete. to be pretty quick with his fingers to start and stop after the ball hit the ground. I'm giving him some credit.
Well, I'm thinking about the mental focus, you know?
Yeah.
Or the mental focus.
Yeah, that's true.
Got to stay with it.
That's true. And here's a big one now. Try to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. They'll set up a throw.
No!
And no! It's incomplete! A gutsy call by Jack Del Rio, but it does not pay off. And the Eagles are going to take over in great field position. Boy, you talk about not playing it safe. Why?
You motherfucker.
Philadelphia getting sent to take the field.
Oh, fuck. I'm going to lose.
Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make
serious
some adjustments.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy
no
territory. And the play goes for 19 yards.
That's over. Yep.
And now Oakland ready to take the field. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit, he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm. A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. A good pick up there, a 22.
And it's over.
So on that play, defense was in the zone. They ran a crossing route offensively, but the defense there, you got to be good with communication, don't you?
You certainly do, and it's not something that is really evident when you watch it on the screen, but everyone's talking, communicating, pointing, and it keeps you from chasing receivers because you have a specific zone you have to cover. When a receiver's in your zone and he crosses to another one, you got to let your guy know. They got a completion there, but I like the discipline they show to stay in their proper areas and then make the tackle.
Oh, and it's incomplete. That would have been big in the end zone if he could have held on. Instead, it's second down.
They may be snapping the ball near the goal line, but all you're thinking defensively, keep them out of the end zone. Force the incompletion, force them into going for three and not giving up six.
And he almost intercepted it. They haven't picked a ball off yet. That probably should have been their first. And it's third down now.
Well, he did almost everything right. Excellent coverage, breaks on the football, just unable to haul it in and take it deep.
And he takes this one into the end zone. And all of a sudden, here in the final minute, things get a little bit tighter. Here we go now as we get set for a big two-point conversion. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a one-score game now. Probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side.
The only way I can offer
it. Hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
And on the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
So still a chance with just over 20 seconds to go, but they need to get this one back, no doubt. And this is going to be recovered by the hand team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. Fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said
here,
the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
And the clock will now stop as a timeout is called with 5 seconds left.
time for this one final knee to put a bow on this title bout. And the Lombardi Trophy will rest in the city of brotherly love. The Philadelphia Eagles are the Super Bowl champs. And their remarkable season ends in the most remarkable of ways. They get to put next to their name, Super Bowl champion.
And they can't ever take that away, can they?
Nope.
That lasts forever. So good to see the emotion when it's all said and done. You see the hugs, you see the guys sharing, the collective happiness. Makes me want to carry you around a little bit on my shoulders to celebrate the triumph. And congratulations to them, a fantastic season.
I need to take a picture of that. Well, that's it, guys. For the season. I tried.